Hugo, you've been at the club 10 years now, and we've got a few special messages from some of your friends. Should we take a look at them?
Let's go.
Let's go.
So I actually bumped into Hugo before he signed in the south of France, and they play like, it's like head tennis on the beach.
Yeah.
And I remember, obviously I knew who he was, and then I remember playing with him. I was like, how is he a goalkeeper? So good with his feet.
We joined in the same window, and then in the season before, we played against each other in the Champions League. He was for Lyon, I played for Ajax in the group stage. And he was probably the main reason he didn't make it through the group stage. At that time when he came, he was already a goalkeeper of the French national team. And yeah, if you're the goalkeeper of the French national team and one of the captains there, you enter in a certain way. You enter with respect, but yeah, he gained more respect, yeah, because of his performances.
When he signed, we added laugh and joke and all that, but like, I was just like, do you know what? How quick he was around the goal.
Well, that was a start, wasn't it? He used to fly out with 10 goals.
Yeah, because normally, like, I'd go through on goal and keepers were about on there trying to set themselves. And I said, like, wow, he's going to be like special.
For 8 years, I was sitting next to him in the dressing room, and that creates a certain connection. And obviously, we spoke both French then. And at that time, there were a lot of French-speaking guys. Moussa was there, then you had Younes Kaboul, Adebayor, later Benjamin Stambouli, Nasser Chadli. It was funny, actually, thinking about those times. Big signing for Spurs at that time, definitely.
There you go, some nice messages there. I saw you laughing and nodding your head. Do you remember those? Do you remember the Jermaine Defoe on the beach?
Yes. No, because I'm not the kind of guy who look at the past, but it's funny because I had different stories and straight away, bang, it's in my mind. And the beach soccer near Saint-Tropez, Saint-Maxime, and was organized by David Ginola. And I think I was 16 or 17. I was close to become a professional, and there was German over there, yeah.
What are your memories of signing for Tottenham?
At that time was a big challenge for me because I wanted to challenge myself to go overseas, and obviously the Premier League at that time was already the best, one of the best league in the world, and when I had this opportunity, I just wanted to come and to compete. But I remember those and German, they were so nice from day one, when I signed, and I think I learned a lot of things from all my teammates, you know, in 10 years.
Love that, lovely to hear. We've got another video. Should we have a look at this one?
Okay. Obviously a fantastic goalkeeper, one of the best in recent history in the Premier League, and like a hard worker, calm guy, you know, but really passionate as well, knows when to send the right message, whether it's in a team talk, whether it's before the game, after the game, a real good leader around the place.
I think he's very, very controlled in his emotions and very friendly to everyone. You know, makes you feel very comfortable if you're a new player or someone who's been here a long time.
Since the first day I joined Spurs, he came to me, started to talk some words in Italian, some in Spanish. From that day, I always had a good relationship with Hugo, and we became friends.
He's been someone who's been incredibly helpful to me in my whole time that I've been here. When I arrived, I was pretty young, and having somebody of his experience, his quality, it gives you a lot of stability. It makes you feel pretty calm.
It's been a pleasure to play with him, and I think now this is my eighth season. Been an amazing captain on and off the pitch. I think I still remember my first season when I struggled. When I came on, I didn't play really well. I was really upset. And Hugo just give a like big hug, and he told me like, yeah, Sonny, keep push, because we need you. That you need to big push. So as a team player, as a captain, I think nothing more to say. I think he's an incredible human being, but also amazing captain to have him behind us.
He even won the World Cup, so everyone listens a bit more, I assume. And
he's a true leader. He's an important player and an important person for the team, always pushing the teammates forward, and Spurs are lucky to have him.
What I loved about that was, Hugo, not just talking about you as a player, but as a person as well. Some lovely messages there, an incredible human being, great leader. How did you react when you saw those?
No, for most of them, I spent many, many hours in a changing room or in travel or And there is a special connection, obviously. And obviously, I feel proud to have the chance to meet that type of players, that type of man. And that's probably the most important thing for me, you know? We are a group of players fighting for the same cause, but you develop a relation and you become even closer, you know, with time. And for sure there's, you know, there will always be a connection for many, many years, you know, all your life.
We've got three more videos to show you, so we'll show you this next one. I think you're gonna like this one.
Those reaction ones, the ones that you just turn around and sometimes think, oh no, that's going bottom corner, that he just gets to. There's too many to name. Sometimes they go under the radar for often. They're just a world-class keeper that we're lucky to have.
You can't just describe one moment. I think Hugo just being a Hugo, you know, like I call him like a cat because he was diving always like a cat and saving the ball amazing all the time. So, you know, having this keeper in the behind us is just incredible. I still clearly remember when we play against Arsenal, obviously also Jan involved the block as well, but when he saved the penalty against Arsenal.
Obviously the Aguero penalty save in the Champions League when we went on to obviously get to the final. I mean, he's pulled off some incredible saves. I remember the save,
I think Watford away last year.
Guy bent it from 25 yards and I was right behind the ball and I just thought it was a goal and he's come out and nowhere, tipped it onto the post. So yeah, he's pulled off some incredible saves.
Dortmund away, that's the save I always think of, you know. When I think of Hugo, the save just now at the weekend against Chelsea, he surprises me all the time with the saves that he makes in training. You know, for a game, he, even now, you know, after he's played for so long.
He's not only the guy who speaks only, the way he trains, the way he gives the players spirit.
He's still so enthusiastic in trading and goal, he still loves it.
So there we go, a lot of iconic saves mentioned there. I remember all of them as well, some brilliant saves mentioned. So I'm intrigued to know, what is Hugo Lloris's favourite ever save for Spurs? Tough one.
Probably one I think I could not repeat. It's one in Bayer Leverkusen in Champions League,
yeah,
away from home. Bit of luck as well, because when I put my hand, I could stop the ball with my hand and I roll over the ball and also I managed to make sure that the ball don't cross the line and this in a fraction of seconds.
Okay, we've heard about Hugo on the pitch. Let's have a listen to Hugo off the pitch.
I know Hugo very well and he's very professional. For me, it was like to find a friend in the club, and he was like this with everybody, a friend, like a teammate. I respect him a lot. We share beautiful moments. We spent 8 years. It's crazy. It's a very long time together, going training together, sharing different type of things. And I love him.
He's very personable, someone you can talk with about anything. His qualities, his leadership qualities are there to see on the pitch, but away from it as well, he's always someone who's happy to lend an ear and have your back in and around the dressing room.
Obviously known him now for a long time, and obviously, early on in our relationship, it was more just a teammate relationship, because obviously I was a young kid, he was playing first team, I was out on loan and etc. As we started playing more and more together, we started building up a friendship. We've been out together, we've been in the same part of on holidays together with our families and kids and stuff. So just a really good guy.
On and off the pitch, so I think Hugo is just a perfect example for me, and I'm learning so many things as well as a captain, as a human being, and also as a player.
You know, he's a World Cup winning captain, still extremely humble, just, yeah, I think a very normal guy, which I think in football is one of the best compliments you can have. We have lots of fun, but I always, and during the winter break, we all flew together somewhere, as my brother Harry, Matt. And I remember I went to the back of the plane and my brother was asleep on like a bed kind of thing, and there was Hugo. There was Hugo asleep on the floor. And that one always makes me laugh. I gave my brother so much abuse for that. But we all did. It was funny because he had Hugo sleeping on the floor, but that was that always makes me laugh, yeah.
Hugo, I've got to ask you about that. Such a down-to-earth bloke that you slept on the floor of a plane so Eric Dier's brother could sleep in the bed. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, but he was already sleeping, so I just respect his sleep, you know. And I felt more comfortable on the floor with a pillow than no, but this is
what a story. Have a listen to the final video message. Let's have a watch.
I mean, 10 years, you know, at a football club, amazing servant, and you know, a top professional. What a goalkeeper, you know, world class, and what he's gone on to achieve. And you know, he's still kicking around a goal, isn't he?
Still now, unbelievable.
Kicking around a goal, like when he first joined.
We won't mention his age because he's younger than me, no, Jay, no, and he's still playing. He'll play for many more years. And
you see
how agile he is. He's still slim. You see, he gets around.
Some of the lads call him Benjamin after Benjamin Button. Yeah,
I call him Benjamin Button. You know, he seems to just get better and better. Still as good as ever physically, mentally. He doesn't seem to be slowing down in any way. I think he can play at, I don't know, the highest level for so long because he just seems the same. But I think obviously that's credit to him and his professionalism and the way that he takes care of himself. I think physically, if you look at him at any time of the year, he just always looks the same, you know, he always looks fit and healthy. Obviously, the rewards are the way that he looks and the way that he performs.
He's like a natural athlete, you know. I think he's just made for being a goalkeeper.
After many years, he's there. He's showing his potential. He fully deserves. He trained so hard. That's why he's fit always.
Really happy that he's here, and like I say, he started the season well. We had an incredible season last year as well. So I know he's looking forward to the rest of the year.
Benjamin Button, tell me about that.
Yeah, Benjamin Button, yeah. That's from Eric, yeah. You need to be careful, you know, because it's a lot of pressure.
It's a lot of pressure, yeah.
I can't go for another car, yeah.
You can't go for another career. Love that. And of course, big achievement, 10 years at one club. Congratulations for that. Is there a highlight that you can put your finger on? Proudest moment at the club so far?
I still believe and I hope that the best will come soon.
Like that, okay.
Yeah. And that's why I'm still working on. But I cannot forget, you know, every time that you bring the fans and the club and the team to a final, but even more for a Champions League final. Amsterdam, it's probably one of the most emotional game,
crazy game, isn't it?
I could live. There is many, many memories. Yeah, 10 years, but believe me, the time is running so fast. You need to enjoy every day. And then I hope the best is ahead with Antonio Conte and his coaching staff, with all the players, and with the help of the fans, with the energy of the fans, and hopefully we will reach something important together.
Love that. Hugo, great answer. Thank you for your time and congratulations on 10 years at the club.
Thank you very much.